Remaining part of the page function I would like to cover today. First we have to see static variables. The variables declared as function parameters which are destroyed on the functions exist. Suppose you store one value for the variable and after execution of that function the scope is over or destroyed on the functions exist, a static variable will not lose its value, but regular variable it's lose its value after termination of that function. Static variable will not lose its value when the function exits and will still hold that value should the function be called again. See the example. You can declare a variable to be static simply by placing the keyword static in front of the variable name. Here function keep track and variable is a dollar count which type is static. It is initialized is equal to 0. Dollar count plus plus then print dollar count. After printing this, first we have to call keep track, then it is increment by 1. Again we have to call that, then it is increment by, it is static variable, therefore its value is 1. After a function is exit, then the value is stored, not lose its the variable not lose its value, and it is 1, then again it increments by 1, then keep track again we have to call, then it will print 2, again keep track will call, then 2 plus 1 3. It is called static variable. Next, here we have to understand the scope of variable. Suppose variables declared within a function are local and they cannot be viewed or manipulated from outside of the function. See the example, function test. Dollar greet is equal to hello world. Echo dollar greet. Dollar greet is the variable which is declared inside the function. Then after calling test function, it outputs hello world. And then if you print echo dollar greet, direct you have to access that variable outside the function, then it will give error because its scope is inside the function. But you want to access that variable outside the function. How to access that? Using global keyword. If you declare that global, then it will access outside the function. See another example. Dollar greet is equal to hello world. It is declared in outside the function. Then function test. Echo dollar greet. You want to access that variable into function. Then after calling test, undefined variable because it is declared outside the function. Echo dollar greet, it will give output hello world because it's declared in outside the function and its scope is not from the function. Therefore, echo dollar greet is not accessible when you call that function. To avoid this type of errors, and you have to declare variable is a global. Dollar greet is equal to hello world. There may be a situation where you need to import a variable from the main program into a function or vice versa. In such cases, you can use the global keyword before the variables inside a function. This keyword returns a variable into a global variable, making it visible or accessible both inside and outside the function. If you declare any variable with global keyword, then it is accessed inside or outside the function. Dollar greet is equal to hello world. If you assign value, one variable is there and you assign one value, then defining function test global dollar grid, echo dollar grid. Here, after calling that function, outputs hello world, because its type is global. Echo dollar grid, it outputs hello world. Suppose dollar grid is equal to goodbye. If you assign value, if you change that variable, then after calling that function test, it will take goodbye, because you change that value, variable's value. After changing, you call that function, then it will take updated value. Echo dollar grid outputs goodbye. Here, recursive function, we have to see another example. Here, returning arrays from functions. In PHP function, multiple values can't be written. Only one value by function. Only one value is written by function. Therefore, we want to return multiple values. Then how to do that? Using array. You have to pass function one function is there, and you have to give the array. Array A is equal to array elements are there. Array A, array B, and array C. Return dollar array means it will return multiple values. Dollar, you have to assign that function to any variable. Then to return multiple values, you have to use array, and then it can return multiple values using arrays. Here, passing an array to a function with PHP. How to pass the array to the function? Here, creates the score array. Score array, 6 elements are there, numbers are there. Function average. Function average, we have to pass the array. Type is dollar array. We have to pass the array. Then dollar total is equal to 0 for each dollar array as a dollar value. Then dollar total is equal to dollar total plus dollar value. This is the logic of function. And then calculate the average and return the result. Return dollar total divided by count of dollar array. Total element, number of elements for the average. Then call the average function and use the scores array as argument. Echo average is equal to average of dollar scores. Dollar scores is the array which is passed through the function. As an argument, you have to pass the array. And you can access passing an array into a function with PHP. First, you have to declare the array, then write the definition of function, and call that function with array. Again, this is the multiple values, how to return multiple values from PHP in function. We have already seen that example. Here, nested functions. Nested means you know nested loops, nested if. One function is there, and inside that function another function is there. This is called nested functions. You have to define first nested function and then outer function, and you have to call that functions. First you have to call syntax, and then define function into function. The total cost in dollars. Here convert pound dollar total. You have to pass the value to calculate convert pound and sell tax. here recursive function. You know the recursion in C programming language. We have to current function, we call current function within function, it is called recursion. Therefore here display dollar number, if dollar number is less than equal to 5, echo dollar number. Then we have to again call display dollar number plus 1. Here display is the function which is recursively called into the code. And here display 1. This is the method which we call recursively. Factorial number, you know the example factorial. For calculation of factorial, no need to explain this because you know the C programming language and definition of recursion, you know. Here, anonymous function is a function without any user defined name. Every program we have to give the name after function, but anonymous function have no name for the function. Function keyword and the opening parenthesis. Directly you have to use function and the opening parenthesis. There is semicolon after the function definition because anonymous function definitions are expressions. End of expression is a semicolon. Wherever function is ended with a semicolon, then this function is anonymous and no name is there. Function is assigned to a variable and called letter using the variable's name. This function definition is assigned to one variable and again you have to call that variable. When passed to another function that can then call it letter, it is known as callback function. When it is passed to another function, that is callback, it is called callback. Return it from within an outer function so that it can access the outer function's variables. This is known as a closure. Return it from within an outer function so that it can access the outer function's variables. This is known as a closure. Here, $var is equal to function $x without name. Return power of $x, 3 and end with brace and semicolon. It is a expression and without name it is an anonymous function. Here we have to store the function to one variable, echo cube of 3 is equal to $var of 3, means we have to pass the value, that is for $x it is a 3. 3 raised to 3 is 27, it will give output. Anonymous function callback, when you assign one function to another function. Suppose here, first you have to see the live demo of this program. Execute, cube of 3 is 27. An anonymous function is used as an argument for a built-in usort function. Usort function sorts a given array using a comparison function. Usort is an inbuilt function of PHP and you have to pass one function, anonymous function, to built-in usort function. Here array is there, 10, 3, 70, 21, 54. Usort function, you have to pass array and function $x and $y. You have to pass anonymous function without name, passing two values, return $x greater than $y. For each dollar array as $x, echo $x. First you have to pass this anonymous function to another function, usort. Then here dollar array as dollar x echo dollar x. It will print the array, sorted array. It will read the array and check elements with each other, and then it will check the element. If it is less, then it will print dollar array value as dollar x. We have to take first two values, then it will check dollar x is greater than dollar y, and if less, it will print the value. Again, it will check for another two values. One by one, it will check and print the value. Here, calling a function dynamically. It is a say hello function. Say hello function have one statement, print hello. This function is stored for one variable, and dynamically you have to treat this variable as a function, dollar function holder. When you want dynamic call a function, then you store that function for one variable and treat that variable as a function. The callback function means you have to store that function argument as an argument into another function. Here, function my callback dollar atom return str length of dollar atom. Suppose this is the definition of one function, then dollar string is equal to apple, dollar length is equal to dollar strings have some one array which contains four strings, and dollar lengths have array map my callback. My callback is the argument for this function, dollar strings and my callback, print dollar lengths. Array map is a function. Array map is a function to calculate the length of every string in an array. It is an inbuilt function which count the length. Then we have to pass callback and string from array. Suppose here it will pass apple, and for apple it checks the length of using str length. It counts the characters of that string and it will display the value, length of that string: apple 5, orange 6, banana 6. And then print r, I have already explained, print r gives details of array: coconut 7. From this, various functions and variable scopes, passing array to function, returning multiple values, passing parameters by value, by reference, how to declare a function, various concepts regarding functions I have covered. I hope you understood all the concepts. Thank you.